Hello and welcome to Just One More Watch. Welcome today to my review of the Spinnaker Fluce, one of their older models but now with a bracelet. I haven't actually reviewed the Fluce before, which is a bit surprising because it is one of their older models and because it is definitely one of their most attractive designs, getting a lot of its aesthetic from the Blancpain 50 Fathoms, which in my humble opinion is no bad thing. You know I don't mind a retro diver. Now, full disclosure, this watch was sent to me for free by Spinnaker. They do quite a bit of seemingly successful marketing on YouTube. So don't just take my word for it, have a look at a whole bunch of other reviews. I'm sure they'll be popping up in your feed right about now. Now, I'm also a Spinnaker affiliate. You will find a 20% discount code in the description of the video. If you buy one of their watches, either this one or anything else using their code, you get 20% off and I get a little bonus payment from the company. So, buy two for you and one for your granny. Let's flip the camera and get on with the review. Well, let's have this long overdue appointment then with the Spinnaker Fluce. Now, the boxes, all Spinnakers come in these very simple little cardboard boxes, kind of like Seiko. It's okay, certainly nothing like a Tissot. I mean, I've unboxed a couple of Tissots recently and you do certainly get a chunk more packaging. There's two sides to that. Mostly the box ends up in a drawer anyway, so a little cardboard thing is not all that bad. What do you get here? Some hashtag by Spinnaker encouraging you to hashtag for discounts, $200 off your next purchase, and a little Spinnaker branded polishing cloth. All very good, but really it is all about the watch. Now, I'm not sure that given the choice, I would necessarily pick this champagne dial. I think the regular black dial one is the one to go for, but hey, that's just me. You may think this one looks beautiful. So dimensions and specifications, it wears really well, this watch, I must say, so I'll get it on wrist inside and out. Loom video, I'll even slap it on the time grapher, see how the Seiko's getting on. So I talked about the Blancpain 50 Fathoms in the intro. Let's get those comparisons out of the way before we proceed. This is the Spinnaker Fluce next to a brand new 50 Fathoms. Yes and no, they've got the domed bezel with a diamond at 12, the Arabics all the way round. They've also got the Arabics at the 3, 12, 6 and 9. Here it is next to a vintage 55 Fathoms and you can see an even stronger set of similarities. Those batons, even the hand shape, the little arrowhead second hand, all very, very similar. But as I said, that is not a bad thing. So 43 millimeters in diameter, bang on 13 mil thick. So it doesn't do too bad in terms of thickness. 50 mil lug tip to lug tip, 22 mil lug width, tapering down to 20, back up to 22 at the clasp. Sized up for my 7-inch wrist, 173 grams, so definitely larger style today. 316L stainless steel case, crown, bezel and bracelet. Solid end links in the bracelet. We've got a see-through case back there as well. I'll show you that shortly. Push pins, you can see the little arrows. Solid links with push pins and it is a proper milled clasp. And I should point out, the bracelet comes with a diver's extension. This watch had previously been available on a kind of waterproof leather strap, so this is, I believe, a bespoke bracelet designed just for the Spinnaker Fluce. So nice to see that they put a bit of extra attention to detail in there with a diver's extension. Kind of three-link oyster, I would say, but kind of raised mid-link, high-polished edges to them. So it's got a bit of chunk to it, this watch, overall. I think the thickness of those links is one of the reasons why it is 173 grams. But if you're going to make a bracelet custom designed for a watch, I think they've done a decent job of this one. Pretty much par for the course for under $300. As is the finishing on the case. Nice fine brushing on the case itself. Little high polish chamfered edge back to brush on the lugs and a reasonable attempt at integrating the brushing, the direction of the brushing and the grade of the brushing between the bracelet and the case itself. I guess this is a bespoke bracelet just made for this Fluce, so they have done a pretty good job. And crucially, it's got that inverted mid-link of the end link, which is one of the reasons why this is a big watch that wears like a much, much smaller watch. Now, they do have a Spinnaker, the kind of Spinnaker sail there on the crown. Crown's a little bit small, to be honest. That will be appearing in the Moans and Niggles section later on. Unguarded though, so it's still quite easy to grip, but it could be doing with an extra mil of girth on that one. Bezel is reasonable, 120 click unidirectional rotating dive time. No backplane, no bounce, the action is okay if not spectacular. But the bezel insert is probably more interesting than the bezel in this case. It is a piece of acrylic, so kind of domed acrylic here, bezel insert, again, very much like the Blancpain. Now I would call this boxed sapphire crystal, little blue tinge to the AR there. Not the most legible of dials though, to be honest. As I said, I would go for the black one if I was picking one of these, but a lot going on this dial, not the least of which is that kind of granular texture on the base of the dial, kind of covering the entire thing. We've got the Spinnaker logo there, always reminds me of a kind of vintage car, Cadillac style. Automatic 500 feet, so this is 150 meters of water resistance, and we have applied batons for most of the indices and those big arabics at the 12, the 6 and the 9. Extra features, little triangles above the arabics and a rather involved minute track and fifth of the minute track plus 5 minute markers. The dial is also a little bit busy. There is just a frame around the date complication at the 3 o'clock. It is color matched though, so if you do go for one of the black ones, it's a black wheel. This champagne version gets a white date wheel. Now the hands, again, some nice texture to those ones, brushed laterally, reasonable size and proportions, sword hands, and there is that nice little diamond tip to the second hand. Overall, the dial is quite busy, but it is definitely attractive. You don't often get an awful lot of detail in a dial at this price on a kind of fully featured automatic diver, so good for Spinnaker for doing something different and putting a lot of attention into that dial. No prizes for guessing what this is today, it's the Seiko NH35. 9 out of 10 cats prefer the NH35. 24 jewels, hacking and hand winding automatic movement, roughly 42 hour power reserve, rugged, robust, reliable and accurate. Screw down case back, screw down crown, giving this one 150 meters of water resistance. The usual spec sheet there advertising all stainless steel, auto movement, the model number, the sapphire and that water resistance rating. Nice of them to put that Spinnaker custom rotor there, not just an engraving on the base rotor, but a proper bespoke custom rotor. Definitely one of the nicest custom rotors that I've seen on these NH35s. Let's get it on the time grapher. So no complaints about this one then, running -4, -5 seconds a day in that default flat on its back position with minimal beat error and a healthy amplitude. There is a reason that these are pretty much ubiquitous at this price. And the lume is pretty good. Unspecified, but judging by that enormous bright green initial burst, I would guess that this is C3 Superluminova. As you can see, the bezel insert is gone after a couple of minutes. It doesn't last, but the hands and the indices hang on in there and just keep hanging on in there. And let's be honest, you're not really going to be taking this one diving too deep anyway, given that it's only got 150 meters of water resistance rated. So I think the fact that the hands and indices hang on in, that's where the practicality is. Not bad at all. And I must say, it wears very well indeed for a larger style of watch. I've got a Joe Average 7-inch wrist. I prefer 40s. I go up to about 42 normally, but this 43 wears pretty sweetly, carries its weight very well. As I said, I think there's a fair chunk of weight in those mid-links, if nothing else, of the bracelet. Now, I'll say it again, that inverted mid-link of the end link is a big factor in how well a watch wears. Nothing worse than a kind of 50-52 lug tip, and then it pushes out even further with a big mid-link. So good choice, Spinnaker, by cutting that, inverting that mid-link. It means that people with average or smaller size wrists will be able to wear this one as well. And that's the overhead shot. Those yellow gold indices and hands rather disappearing on the champagne dial. As noted, this one not the most legible of the different variants, but sits sweetly, solid big watch, but wears well. And outside that box sapphire crystal, I'm not sure how much of that anti-reflective coating is on there. I guess Spinnaker can say, hey, we're just copying the 50 fathoms, it didn't have any, so we don't have much on ours. But an extra couple of layers would not have gone amiss. That's it on my wrist, a little bit of curvature to the lugs, nicely sloping case. And I'm not going to talk about those mid-links again, but they're good. Moans and niggles. Well, the champagne dial, as I have said a couple of times, would not be my choice at all. Bit of an odd colour. And the dial itself is quite full on. They could have done with removing a couple of elements. Those
triangles, it had the indices, and I could have cut that down to a minute track. I think it would have looked a little bit cleaner. They've just done a bit too much on the dial, I think. And the crown looks like a carryover from an older series of watches, this one. I know the Fluus is one of their early models. I think they could do with upgrading that. Just doesn't quite match the rest of the watch. And the bracelet, as nice as it is, I believe it is a custom bracelet for this watch. Little bit of N-Link rattle there. Maybe a better set of spring bars in there would help with that. But I must say that in terms of the base set of specifications that this watch offers, the level of finishing of the case and the level of detailing on the dials, you get an awful lot of watch for $280. Spinnaker's still a relatively new brand in the marketplace, only been around for three and a half years. That is not going to be enough, I understand, to tempt people away from Seikos and Orients, and that is fair enough. But if you're looking for a bigger style, retro diver, I think you could definitely do a lot worse than to have a crack at one of these Spinnaker Fluus.
So there you have it, the new Spinnaker Fluus. Well, new because it's on a bracelet this time. I think a pretty good watch actually for $280. Love that retro vintage styling, a lot of detailing on the dial with that kind of texture pattern, and it's a good bracelet. I am a 100% a bracelet guy. $280 sub $300 is a pretty competitive price point, but I think if you're looking for a kind of larger style but wears well retro diver, the Spinnaker Fluus with the bracelet should be on your shopping list. It ticks a lot of boxes. Don't forget the 20% discount code in the description of the video. Don't forget to tune in to the next one. Thanks for watching. I will see you then.